Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to restore your Windows 11 to earlier created system restore point, and basically we will see how to use system restore feature in Windows 11 to recover your system. So in case if you have recently installed any Windows update and after that your system is not working as expected, or if your system is not working as expected due to anonymous reason, you can use system restore to restore it back to an earlier point when it was working fine. So let's get started. First of all, we will right click on the start button and select run, type sysdm.cpl and click OK. Under system properties, go to system protection tab, and here you can see that protection is turned off for the system root drive, that is C drive, on which Windows is installed and due to which the system restore is grayed out. So we will first need to enable system protection. For this, we will click on configure button and then select turn on system protection and click apply followed by OK. Now you can see that the system restore button is now available, which was earlier grayed out. If we click on it, we can see that here we have no restore points created because we just enabled the system protection. Now we can click on the create button to create a system restore point. Kindly note that you must have a system restore point created in advance, because if something went wrong later, you can easily use that system restore point. Then you have to type in a name for the restore point. So type in a name by which you can easily recognize this system restore point later while restoring the system, and click on create button. In few seconds, you will see that system restore point has been created. Here we have information that the restore point was created successfully. Now if you go to system restore, you can easily locate this system restore point by clicking on next. And here it is, the system restore point we just created manually. Note that the system restore points created by Windows will have auto labeled. From here, you can select the restore point and click on next, but we will not use this method. We will instead use the another recovery environment method, because in case if you run into an issue that prevents you from booting, you can use system recovery options. For that, you have to go to system recovery, advanced startup, and click restart now. Click on restart now button. In case if your system is unable to boot, you can access advanced recovery options using the instructions mentioned in this video. These instructions are also mentioned in the video description. When your system restarts, under choose an option, click troubleshoot. Advanced options, system restore. As you can see that system restore window has now started. Click on next button here. Locate the earlier created system restore point and click next. You can also click on scan for affected programs here to see which programs will be affected. This will help you to decide whether to restore to that restore point or not. In the next window, confirm all the details and click on finish button. After this, a prompt will appear. Click yes in that. And now the system restore process has been started and it is now restoring files. This process may take time depending upon the data you have to restore the system. So after a while, the system restore is now finalizing. And here you can see that system restore is completed successfully and the system has been restored to the date and time is mentioned there. your documents have not been affected, click restart button to restart the computer. So you can click on the restart button and your system will be rebooted, and after that the system will be finally restored to the system restore point you have selected, and the issues you were facing will be resolved because you have restored to an earlier system restore point when your system was working absolutely fine. So we will log in after the restart. After login, on the desktop we have here again the message: system restore completed successfully, the system has been restored to date, your documents have not been affected. So this is how you can use system restore to restore your system to an earlier date when it was working perfectly. And that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.